Wentworth Catholic District School Board is situated upon the traditional territories of the Erie, Neutral, Huron-Wendat, Haudenosaunee, and Mississaugas. This is covered by the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Belt Covenant, which was an agreement between the Haudenosaunee and Anishinaabe to share and care for the resources around the Great Lakes. We further acknowledge that this land is covered by the Between the Lakes Purchase, 1792, between the Crown and the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation. Please stop and stand for the singing of our national anthem.
Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Loving God, during the sacred season of Lent, bring me closer to you. Prepare a place in my home and heart for silence and solitude, so that I may rediscover the grace of a prayerful life. Help me to fast from those things that threaten the well-being of body and soul. Remind me of the grace of simplicity. Enlarge my heart so that I give to those in need, and in doing, rediscover the grace of gratitude and generosity. May this season be a grace-filled time to rekindle my love for and faith in you. Amen. Bishop Brian, pray for us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
It's Abdullah from your BRSC with a couple of important announcements. First, an announcement from Mrs. Roberto. Attention all specialist high skills major graduates. Please go on your graduation LMS and order your t-shirt for Schism Day. The deadline is this Friday. Thank you. And a message from Mrs. Mazza. Mrs. Mazza will be accepting cash for grad fees and student services. Hurry, because the deadline is March 1st this Monday. This must be paid if you wish to participate in graduation. Thank you, Mrs. Mazza. And now a few reminders from your BRSC. Today we recognize anti-bullying awareness by wearing pink shirts. This awareness came to be when a high school student had decided to wear a pink shirt to school one day and was bullied for it. The bullying was witnessed by David Shepherd and Travis Price, who decided to take action rather than sit back and be a bystander. They spread the word to wear a pink shirt the next day and ordered 50 to distribute themselves. We now commemorate their heroic stance against bullying by standing against bullying ourselves. It is not a matter which should be taken lightly, as 1 in 5 kids are affected by bullying. For more information, visit pinkshirtday.ca. Thanks for showing your support in wearing pink today. In addition to wearing a pink shirt, we are hosting an anti-bullying poster contest. Please submit your poster to our Instagram, which is @bishop_ryansc via DM. Posters can be either hand-drawn or electronically created. All submissions are due tomorrow. And now for some exciting news. We will be having Spirit Wear Days on Monday, March 1st for Cohort A and Tuesday, March 2nd for Cohort B in honor of what would have been our patron, Bishop J.F. Ryan's 124th birthday. Don't forget to wear your best BR Spirit Wear top with uniform bottoms on Monday and Tuesday next week. Finally, be sure to follow us on social media, which is again @bishop_ryansc, so that you can stay up to date on the exciting events that we have planned for you. That's all from me. Stay tuned for more announcements and have a great day.
Hey Celtics, it's that time of year again. It's time to register for September. So go on School Cash Online, pay your $40 activity fee, and get on MyPath and choose your courses. What are you waiting for? Do it today.
Good morning, Bishop Ryan. Before we get into our fire drill announcement, I just wanted to point out that today, in support of Pink Shirt Day, we asked the students have the BR pants on with any kind of pink item on top. So it's important that we have our BR uniform as pant. Okay, so I'm here to talk to you about the fire drill. So as part of the orders from Health and Safety and the Fire Marshal, and now with Public Health, we are required to continue with safety drills. Today we will conduct a fire drill. Procedures have been sent to all staff to review with students. The overcrowding generally associated with total evacuation fire drills in schools may lead to an increased risk of COVID-19 transmission. As such, we will be taking a flexible and balanced approach when undertaking fire drills. This year's recommendation and directives provide our school with flexibility so that all occupants of the school do not need to evacuate simultaneously, so as to ensure COVID-19 physical distancing requirements and the wearing of masks is adhered to. Therefore, we will be implementing the drill in a staggered and scheduled evacuation process. This approach complies with the fire code requirements for schools by local fire departments. After this announcement, a one-time sounding of the fire alarm will be sounded to familiarize all students and staff with the sound of the fire alarm. Individual classrooms will be evacuated as per the scheduled times indicated below. Therefore, only a few classrooms will be evacuating simultaneously from 8:45 to 10:45. The teacher in the classroom may use their cell phone to set a timer, ringer, or alarm to simulate the sound of the fire alarm and to commence the individual classroom evacuation at the scheduled time. Staggered evacuations will take place from 8:45 to 10:45 this morning. With the support of the teachers, classes will exit with their students in a manner that ensures coordinated physical distancing. Teachers should also practice the regular duties assigned under the fire safety plan, which is to ensure the closing of windows and doors when leaving the classroom. Once the class has exited the school, the teacher is to ensure the students maintain a minimum distance of 15 meters, 50 feet from the building. Once the evacuation is complete and the teacher is satisfied that the class understands what they need to do in case of a fire, students and teacher may return to class maintaining the same physical distancing protocol. Please ensure that when the students return to the classroom that they sanitize their hands. It is important to note that where a fire alarm sounds outside of the scope of a planned scheduled fire drill, the total evacuation of the school shall proceed as pre-COVID fire drill procedures. This means that the entire school will evacuate at the same time. If any member of the emergency response team would like to meet at 11 a.m. today in the chapel for a debrief, please do so by emailing your attendance first. Thank you for your cooperation and staying safe in all we do. At this time, I'd like you to please pay attention to the sign, fire sign, that's in your class that outlines your exit. Thank you. At this time, I'm going to radio our school custodial team. Mr. Edworthy?
Yes, sir.
Can you sound the alarm, sir? Thank you, Bishop Brian.